So the impeller power is given by the formula rho q into Vw to U2. So you have to remember, for a pump, the input power is a shaft power, which is supplied by the electric motor. So electrical energy is the input power or shaft power. Then after shaft power, there is the impeller power, which is the work done by the impeller on the water, which is given by rho q into Vw to U2. Okay. In terms of head, it will be given by Vw to U2 upon G. Okay. Vw to U2 upon G. So it is intermediate power, that is impeller power, rho q Vw to U2. And after that, there is a final, that is the manometric power or manometric head. Okay. Which is given by rho g q hf. So you have to remember three powers as like that of turbine. For turbine, we have seen input power, runner power and output power, that is a shaft power. In this case, the shaft power is the input power, then there is a impeller power, and then there is a manometric power or the manometric head causing the power. So the shaft power is the maximum power in case of centrifugal pump. After shaft power, there is a impeller power which is reducing. Okay. And after impeller power, there is a manometric power which is again reducing. So output is reducing, as we know. So efficiency is there, output upon input. So like in case of turbine, we have seen that three types of efficiencies mainly, which was hydraulic efficiency, mechanical efficiency and overall efficiency. Here also we are going to see three types of efficiency. Okay. Only in reverse manner. Now let us see. Only you have to remember the sequence. First one is the shaft power, which is input power. Then there is the impeller power, which is intermediate power. And then there is a manometric power, which is the output power. So let us see the definition of efficiencies. So if you remember, the hydraulic efficiency in case of turbine, that is replaced by manometric efficiency. In this case, the hydraulic efficiency is called as a manometric efficiency. Then there is mechanical efficiency. It is same. Okay. Which is associated with runner power and shaft power. Okay. So that mechanical efficiency is same, and overall efficiency. Okay. Which is nothing but product of these two, manometric and mechanical efficiency. So the sequence is same. Okay. The manometric efficiency. Now if you take the sequence, the shaft power is the maximum and manometric power is the minimum. Okay. So in between shaft power and manometric power, there is a impeller power. Okay. In between that. So let us take from manometric power to impeller power. Okay. The efficiency associated with manometric power and impeller power, that is called as a manometric efficiency. We know manometric head is the, or manometric power is the least one. After that, impeller power, okay, that is somewhat to greater than manometric power, and then shaft power is the maximum one. So here manometric efficiency is defined as the ratio of manometric head to the head imparted by the impeller to the water, or it is also called as the manometric power divided by the impeller power. So if you take in terms of head, it will be HM upon VW to U2 upon G, because VW1 was 0, so it is only VW to U2 upon G. So the formula for manometric power, manometric efficiency is GHM upon VW to U2. This formula you have to remember. This formula you have to remember, that manometric head is given by the formula GHM upon VW to U2 for the centrifugal pump. Okay. Then there comes the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is nothing but it is associated with the impeller power and the shaft power. Okay. So shaft power is the maximum one. Okay. And impeller power is less than the shaft power. So it is the ratio of impeller power to the shaft power. Hence it is given by impeller power, you know, okay. It is given by rho q into Vw to U2. This is the impeller power, and shaft power, that is generally given in the numerical. So shaft power is given. So you have to remember these two formulas, that is mechanical efficiency is given by rho q Vw to U2 upon shaft power, and the manometric efficiency is given by GHM upon Vw to U2. Okay. GHM upon Vw to U2. And the product of these two, that is the manometric efficiency and mechanical efficiency, is nothing but overall efficiency. Overall efficiency is nothing but output upon input. Output is your manometric head and input is your shaft power. So it is rho g q h m, that is the output power, upon shaft power, that is the input power. And that ratio is called as a overall efficiency. So it's a very easy to remember three types of efficiencies, that is manometric, mechanical and overall efficiency. Now let us see some of the numericals based on this centrifugal pump. 100% there is one numerical coming for 10 to 12 marks in exam for centrifugal pump. Okay. So you have to solve the numerical. The numericals are very simple. for centrifugal pump, and only one velocity diagram you have to remember for solving all the numericals on the centrifugal pump that we have seen. This is the velocity diagram which you have to remember for any type of centrifugal pump. So if the numerical comes on the centrifugal pump, you have to draw this diagram. Okay, we have seen the inlet velocity triangle, okay, which was the outlet velocity triangle for Francis turbine, that is the inlet velocity triangle for the centrifugal pump. So in that case VW2 was 0, in this case VW1 is 0. So here alpha is 90 degree, that's why VW1 is 0. So to get maximum output from the impeller, you are getting this alpha as a 0, so that you are getting VW2U2/G, that is the maximum output. So here the discharge is radial at inlet, okay, and this is the outlet velocity triangle. So inlet velocity triangle, as alpha is equal to 90 degrees, so V1 is equal to VF1, okay, VW1 is 0. So there is a, between VR1 and V1 there is U1, between V1 and VF1 there should be VW1, but they are equal, that's why VW1 is 0. The angle made by VR1 is theta, okay. Similarly, outlet velocity triangle, if you see the outlet velocity triangle, so this is VR1 coming inlet, so VR2 going outlet, okay, VR2 going outlet. So this is the backward curved vane, okay, for backward curved vane, this is the only outlet velocity triangle that you have to remember, okay. So this is the VR2 making an angle phi, okay, with the horizontal. Then this is VF2, which is the radial velocity, like VF1, okay, it is in the same direction of that of the VF1. So VF2 is the radial or flow velocity, and V2 is the resultant velocity, that is the resultant velocity which is coming out from the impeller, okay. So it is the outlet velocity, so it is making an angle beta with the horizontal, making an angle beta with the horizontal. So if you remember, in between V2 and VF2 there is VW2, in between V2 and VF2 there is VW2, in between V2 and VR2 there is U2, in between V2 and VR2 there is U2. So you see here U2 is greater than VW2, okay. So that is because it is a backward curved vane. So you have to remember this diagram, always remember by this way, that in between V2 and VR2 you are going to take U2, in between V2 and VF2 you are going to take VW2, okay. Likewise, you have to remember the angle made by V2 with horizontal is beta, angle made by VR2 with horizontal is phi. Okay, that is so simple to remember. Now let us see the numerical. First numerical, the internal and external diameters of the impeller of a centrifugal pump are 200 mm and 400 mm respectively. The pump is running at 1200 rpm. The vane angles of the impeller at inlet and outlet are 20 degree and 30 degree respectively. Means the vane angles are given, the vane angles are nothing but your theta and phi. Okay, remember the absolute velocity angles are alpha and beta, okay, and the runner vane angles are nothing but theta and phi. These are vane angles, okay, or relative velocity angles, which are nothing but vane angles. 20 degree is theta and 30 degree is phi. The water enters the impeller radially, means what? The discharge is radial, so alpha is 90 degree and velocity of flow is constant, so VF1 is equal to VF2. Determine the work done by the impeller per unit weight of water. So let us see, in short we have to find impeller power, okay, per unit weight of water. So let us write the given data. Diameter at inlet, okay, it is smaller, at outlet it is greater. So inlet diameter is 200 mm, it is 0.20 meter. Outlet diameter is 400 mm, which is 0.40 meter. RPM is 1200 rpm. Theta is 20 degree. Phi is 30 degree. Alpha is 90 degree. So VW1 is 0, as we have seen already. VF1 is equal to VF2. Now it is given, D1 is given, D2 is given, RPM is given. So U1 you can easily find as pi D1 n by 60. Okay, so U1 is coming as 12.56 meter per second. Similarly, U2 can be found by pi D2 n by 60. So D2 is given, n is given. So it is coming twice that of U1. So it is 25.13 meter per second, that is U2. From inlet velocity triangle, now U1 is known. Okay, U1 is known. Theta is known. Theta is known. So you can find V1 or VF1 as well as VR1. Okay, so if you see tan of theta is equal to VF1 upon U1. So VF1 is easily, it can be easily found. So VF1 is equal to U1 tan theta. So U1 is 12.56 into tan of 20. So it is 4.57 meter per second. So VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 4.57 meter per second. Hence, from outlet velocity triangle. So what you have to find? Work done, right? So you have to find, you have found U2 also. So your aim is to find VW2. Okay. So from outlet velocity triangle, If you see tan of phi is equal to Vf2 upon U2 minus Vw2, U2 minus Vw2. So tan of 30 is equal to Vf2 is nothing but Vf1, 4.57 divided by U2 minus Vw2. U2 is 25.13 minus Vw2. So everything is given. You can find Vw2. So 25.13 minus Vw2 is equal to 4.57 upon tan of 30. Okay, which will give you Vw2 as 17.215 meter per second. And hence the work done by the impeller per kg of water per second is given by the equation, that is nothing but Vw2 U2 upon g. It is nothing but the Euler's head. Okay, Vw2 is 17.215. So you can put that value. U2 also 25.13 upon g 9.81. So it will be the answer 44.1 Newton meter per Newton. So this is a simple numerical, okay, on the centrifugal pump. Let us see one more numerical. A centrifugal pump delivers water against a net head of 14.5 meters and a design speed of 1000 rpm. The vanes are curved back to an angle of 30 degree with the periphery. Okay, the impeller diameter is 300 millimeter and outlet width is 50 mm. Determine the discharge of the pump if manometric efficiency is 95%. Okay, so now given data, you have to write the data given. HM, that is manometric head, is given as which we have to produce. The pump has to produce 14.5 meter of water. RPM is 1000 RPM. Phi is the angle 30 degree. Now some of you may confuse that this is theta. No, it is with the periphery. With the periphery means outer one. Okay, so it is phi. Okay, associated with outlet velocity triangle. So phi is equal to 30 degree. Then diameter at outlet. Okay, impeller diameter is given as 300 mm. So you have to take outer diameter 0.3 meter. Then similarly B2, that is the width. Okay, 0.05 meter. Why B2 is given? Because similar to Francis turbine, the discharge is also calculated as pi D2 B2 Vf2 in this case. That's why it is given. Okay, to take discharge into account. Okay. To calculate discharge. Manometric efficiency, we know manometric efficiency is nothing but the ratio of manometric power to the impeller power. Okay, so it is manometric power to the impeller power. So that efficiency is given. Tangential velocity of the impeller at outlet. So U2 you can easily find because D2 is given, N is given. So you can immediately find U2. Always draw the velocity diagram first. The velocity diagram remains same for all the numericals. So same diagram you have to remember. So U2, once you calculate, it is coming 15.70. After calculating U2, you know phi. Okay, you can easily calculate, okay, Vf2. Okay, so manometric efficiency is given by the formula we know, GHM upon Vw2 U2. GHM upon Vw2 U2. So from this manometric efficiency, everything is given. You have to, you know HM, you know U2. Okay, so manometric efficiency is 95%. So Vw2 can be known. Okay, so they have found from manometric efficiency, Vw2 is found first, and then you can find Vf2. Okay, as we have seen from the outlet velocity triangle, tan of phi is equal to Vf2 upon U2 minus Vw2. So U2 is known, okay, phi is known. So here you can calculate Vf2 because Vw2 is already found, 9.54. So here Vw2 is required, that's why you have to find Vw2 first. So tan of 30 is equal to Vf2 upon 15.70 minus 9.54. So this will give you Vf2 upon 6.16. So Vf2 will come as 6.16 into tan of 30. So it is coming as 3.556 meter per second. And I have told you that this B2, that is the width of the vein, is given for calculating the discharge. And discharge is calculated by using the formula Q is equal to pi D2 B2 Vf2. Pi D2 B2 Vf2. So Q is equal to pi into 0.30 into 0.05 into Vf2, it is 3.556. So it is Q is coming as 0.1675 meter cube per second. So because you have to find the discharge, okay, for the pump. So discharge, to find discharge, the formula is same as that of the Francis turbine, pi D2 B2 Vf2. So our aim was to find Vf2. Only Vf2 was unknown. To find Vf2, you have to do so much calculation, too much calculations, because you know, you don't know either Vf1 or Vf2. Okay, next we'll see some more numericals. Thank you.